So welcome to Pbtech, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can actually scan for the Eutelsat 16A on a 16 degrees east on your Redline FTA decoder. So if you are about to track for the Eutelsat 16A, or you are having a stable signal but you are looking for the right step just to scan on your Redline decoder, follow this video till the end. So all you got to do is to connect the cable from your satellite dish after having a stable signal, or if you are about to add a TP and then do the necessary settings and then track for the signal, connect your cable well at the back of your Redline decoder. That's the LMB input at the back of the decoder, and press on the menu button on the remote. So from the menu here, you have some options over here. Use the arrow keys just to move through the menu, and then you look for installation. So you put it on installation and you press OK. So from the installation page, you have antenna setting, satellite list, transponder list, motor setting, DVB-T, DVB-C. So for the satellite settings, these three options over here: antenna setting, satellite list, transponder list, and the motor setting as well. That's where you're going to use it for the satellite setting. And we have the DVB-T and the C, that's for the digital or the terrestrial setting. So you come to the first option, you press OK on it. That's the antenna setting. And from this antenna settings page, you have on the top of the list, that's the satellite option, which the Eutelsat 16A pre-installed satellite folder. That's the first option on the list. That's why it's been selected over there. So this the satellite that we are talking about. So you select the right satellite option. If you are using the same steps on your FTA decoder, it might be that the Eutelsat 16A is not available on your decoder. So you can select a different satellite folder, and then you follow the same process by adding the right TP, and then you scan or you track to get a signal, and you proceed to scan to get the channel. So you press OK, or you select the TP or the satellite. All right, so you select the satellite over here. That's the Eutelsat 16A, and you come to LMB type. It's supposed to be KU band. So if it's a C band, with the satellite folder that you selected, you change it to the KU band. The LMB frequency is supposed to be a universal figure, so you place it on this option, and you come to the transponder. That's where you need to add the primary TP, which you're going to use to track or scan for the Eutelsat 16A channels, as the French channels or the MyTV Africa FTA channel. So from this list, you are likely not to find a primary TP in it. So all you have to do is to add. So with the other options over here, the LMB power supposed to be on, and the dissect option supposed to be off, since you are not doing multiple LMB installations. So it's supposed to be off, or select the none over there. So with a transponder, if you are to add a transponder on this page, you cannot add. So you need to press exit and you go back to the transponder list page. You press OK on it, and here that's where you can add the TP. So if in case you select a different satellite folder, when you come to the menu, you need to select that satellite folder for you to add the TP. So for you to select the right satellite folder, which you're going to use to track or scan, you need to press on the stop button on the remote for the satellite option to pop up, and then you place it on it. So let's select hotbed as a different satellite folder, which you are not having the Eutelsat 16A on your FTA decoder. And the next thing is to add. So with the adding, you press on the red button as the command below states: red to add, green to edit, yellow to delete, and then blue to scan. So you press on the red button on the remote and you add a TP, which I'm going to highlight on your screen, which is 10804 30k 30,000 3000 horizontal. So you change it to H horizontal. All right, then you come here and then you highlight the save option, and then you press OK on it to save, and then you highlight it right there. So as you can see, the signal quality is blinking over there. It's supposed to show a stable signal, which indicating that there is a signal from the satellite. This, all right. After reaching this level, if you are yet to track for the signal, all you got to do is to go straight to the satellite dish, and then you turn it around. You made it face the east, 16 degrees on your northeast, and you turn it a bit just to get your stable signal. So the next option is to scan. So let's select our previous satellite, which is the Eutelsat 16A. It rotates at 16A on a 16 degrees east. So you select the right satellite folder if it's available on your decoder, and then you place it on the primary TP. All right. So with the scan option, you can proceed by scanning on this page, which you are limited only on the manual section. So you can press on the blue button for the scan menu to pop up, and as you can see, you can change the scan type, which is being limited on or locked it on the manual search. So all you have to do with the manual search, you are to get only few channels. So let's go ahead and then scan for you to know the number of channels that you're gonna get. Only few channels will be over here. So even there is no program, so all you got to do is to go back. After adding the TP, you press on the exit button, you go back, you come to the antenna setting, and you select your right satellite folder. If you add a TP on the hotbed satellite folder, you select the hotbed, and then you come to the TP option over here, you place it on the added TP, and then you proceed by following the same steps, place it on the blue button to scan. So we want to select our Eurotest at 16A, the 16 degrees east. And then, since the tip is already added, the primary tip is already in it, so we will proceed to perform the search. Or you can just place it on the primary tip, which the TP or the signal quality will show, indicating that there is a signal from the satellite dish. So you place it on the primary TP, which the signal quality will let you know that there is a signal. So as you can see, there is a flash of the signal quality over there. So the next step is to press on the blue button for the scan menu to pop up, and you select your scan type, change it from auto to blind, and the channel type too, you can leave it on all or select FT only to eliminate those scramble channels which will not be available for you to watch. So you can select FTA only, FTA only over here, for it to eliminate all those scramble channels, or you can leave it on all, and then you press OK for the start search to begin. All right, so that's it. If you have watched this video up to this far and you are new to the channel, all you have to do is subscribe, hit the bell icon, and you keep coming back for more. If you are an old subscriber too, thanks for supporting the channel. All you have to do is to share, you like the video, and you keep coming back for more. So you want to leave this on for it to complete scanning, then you want to get access to the channels that will be available with the TP, which you are having a stable signal from the satellite. So that's it. Bless up. I'm walking alone, the streets are empty. The only thing I can see is my own silhouette. I'm getting stronger, step by step. Clock is ticking, but there's no time for me. I've been flying from town to town, from London to Taiwan. I've been all around the globe trying to protect your soul.